If you are a spiritually minded person, should you get married or not, or get hitched onto the normal sansar style of life?
Majority of human beings, again, people who are spiritually oriented, it's better for them to get married, bluntly. Because you can be spiritual in if you like, in this family surrounding. Sometimes it's better. So sometimes it's better to make spiritual progress in a family surrounding. Why? Because then you see you've got a little family to look after. So in a way, you begin to try and live for them. Haven't you seen all the parents live for their children nowadays? Everywhere in the world, we kill ourselves for our children. So you're now beginning to live for others in the family surrounding. But then say, don't be mean and just say, me and my bachu and this is my life. Try and expand the idea of people you call your very own to be people who are not that closely related to you, maybe in your same community, same in the same culture. So try and expand the people you call your very own and try and relate to them. So you become spiritual in a gradual manner, your family first, then a greater community. And by living for greater good, you are becoming spiritual within the confines of a family life. Look, I'm doing that myself. So I'm telling you, this is the easier way. Becoming a monk, you know, embracing a celibate lifestyle, joining a monastic order with all the strict disciplines that come with it, perhaps would not suit majority human beings. It wouldn't suit me, for example. So I would say, leave it open. I mean, if somebody is so like Vivekananda, I can tell Vivekananda, get married. He's a go away, get lost. So if there are people who are hell-bent, quite keen to lead a celibate life as a monk's life and kind of, you know, devote their whole life for the greater world, I say they are very special, but majority human beings, I would suggest, perhaps operating in a family circle is perhaps the most safer and easier way to progress spiritually.